till I overflow. I wanna run over. I wanna run over. I wanna run over. The third song says, you prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. And my cup runs over. I believe that the reason that our cup runs over is because what we have has not been for us. And I mean that to say that what we have is not just meant for us. I think oftentimes people in church and people that say that they are believers forget the commission that Christ left for us. He said, go therefore and make disciples. That means to go and to make more of, to make others like us. It's a reiteration of the charge that is given in Genesis 1, 26 and 26 to 28, where he says, be fruitful and multiply. It says in Genesis that we were created. He said, let us make man in our image and after our likeness. So he created man and woman, male and female, in the image and likeness of God. But we can't look like God if we are not duplicating and replicating Him in the earth. When we become saved, when we become born again, there's a seed that is planted inside each and every one of us. Seed is called the Holy Spirit, the Helper, the Paraclete. It is God with us always and forever. It's what Jesus promised when he said, I'm not going to leave you nor forsake you, but I'm going to leave with you the Holy Spirit. I'm going to leave with you a helper. And it's not just to help us walk through our days, because oftentimes we get hung up on that. We get hung up on allowing the Holy Spirit to help us move from day to day, help us make decisions, help us make God-honoring decisions, help us to do the right thing, helping us to be holy. But it's not just meant for us. We're supposed to go and make disciples. We are supposed to go and replicate ourselves, duplicate ourselves, using the seed of the Holy Spirit that's planted within us. And as that seed blossoms and grows, then we see the fruit of the Spirit as it's outlined in Galatians chapter 5. The fruit of the Spirit being love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. There's no law against these things. So, how does a tree make more trees? It drops its fruit, and within the fruit is the seed. If man was to never interfere, what you would see happen with trees is that the fruit after ripening would fall to the ground and the seed would plant and nature would take its course with the soil and the sunlight and the water fertilizing this seed. The seed is fertilized and begins to germinate and sprout. You then see a sapling come. Then that sapling grows into a tree. It may be a small tree, but it is yet still a tree. And the cycle continues and continues and continues. God has painted a picture for us in nature of what our life is supposed to be like as believers. We're supposed to be dropping fruit around us. We're supposed to be sharing love around us. We're supposed to be sharing joy around us. We're supposed to be displaying peace around us. We're supposed to show gentleness around us, self-control around us. And Jesus says, he says in the parable, that some seeds fall on thorny ground, some seeds fall on rocky ground, some seeds fall on good ground. It's not our job to control what type of ground receives the seed. It's simply our job to cast it. I'll say that again. It's not our job to control what type of ground receives the seed. But it's simply our job to cast it. It's our job to throw the seed, to share the seed far and wide. And the good ground will catch it. The thorny ground may try, but there'll be things that are hindering it, that are keeping it from fully blossoming what it could be, what it should be. There are some people that are going to be rocky ground, that you're going to share love, peace, joy, the gospel of Jesus Christ with them. And their hearts will be hard. And that's okay. It's not our job to save everyone. That's God's. It's simply our job to share him and to make him available and to make him known to people. It's one thing for someone to reject Christ, but it's another thing for someone to never even know he exists. So, I encourage you, if you're watching live, if you're watching the playback of this, I encourage you to scatter your seed, to sow your seed. There's a seed, there's something that God has placed inside of you. wonderful way of manifesting himself in multiple ways. Yes, there's the fruit of the Spirit that we all are called to display. But then there are the gifts of the Spirit. It could be a song like what I've been doing tonight. It could be a word. It could be compassion. It could be a servant's heart, a servant's touch. It could be order and organization. It could be prophecy. It could be wisdom. It could be insight. It could be encouragement. But whatever it is your responsibility to share it with the world, with as many people as you can, with as many people as you encounter. Like the parable with the servants of the talents, the Lord is going to ask you one day, what did you do with the talents I gave you? What did you do with the gifts I gave you? It's important that we remember that it's not a gift. The gift is not our own. The talent is not our own. But it comes from God, and it belongs to God, and it's supposed to be used for His glory.